Welcome to the best news in town. This is our Agnhart student-led morning announcements, and I'm Kestrel. I'm in third grade and in Miss Chan's class. And my funniest slash favorite moment in online school so far is art, because I can get to chat with my friends. Now for lunch. Lunch is one of my favorite meals of the day. When I was back in school, my favorite thing to eat was chocolate milk with carrots and a PB&J. Now at home, my favorite thing to have for lunch is a bagel and cream cheese. What are you having?
Now it is time for a very special birthday wish.
Good morning, Agnhart. This is Mrs. Ritchie. I am teaching in fourth and fifth grade multi-age, and I am here today to wish two very special kids a super, super birthday. First, Elena in my class, feliz cumpleaños, and Gabriel in Miss Murray's class, we wish you a happy birthday too. Happy birthday, guys. I really hope that your birthday shines. Work hard today, everyone. And if you see these two, make sure that you tell them happy birthday too. Bye.
National Day. Today is National Mexican Independence Day, National Guacamole Day, National Dot Week, and National Choose Your Own Chocolate Day. Yum!
Agnhart News! Did you know that our school has families from over 15 different countries and there are over 13 different languages at our school?
Wow!
Right now, we are celebrating Hispanic Latino Heritage Month. It is not only fun to learn about other people's cultures, but it teaches us to respect one another for things we have in common, but also our differences. Check out one of our amazing teachers sharing books that help us celebrate.
September 15th, which means it is an extra special day because it is the first day of Latinx Heritage Month, a whole month where we learn more about Latin American countries and all of our Spanish-speaking friends here in the U.S. that celebrate those cultures and traditions. Today, I am here to talk to you about one of my favorite books, Paola Santiago and the River of Tears. It is about a Mexican-American girl named Paola who lives near a river in Arizona where everyone talks about this lady called La Llorona, because La Llorona might get you. And that never happens, but then one day her friend goes missing and it's up to Pao and her best friend to figure out what's going on in the river and if there's really spirits and mythical creatures, or the way Pao likes to think about it, if it all just comes down to science and there's a perfectly logical explanation for everything. It is a very fun book. It is spooky. It is full of adventure. It's getting made into a TV show too. So I highly, highly recommend you check it out. Look for it in your library or buy it online. Paola Santiago and the River of Tears. Very, very fun.
Do you know what herping is? I do. If you have ever gone out looking for reptiles or amphibians, then you have been herping. I've found skinks and frogs and toads and snakes in our pool. Riddle for the day. Yesterday's riddle. What do you get when you drop a pumpkin? Answer, squash. Get it? Today's riddle. Why couldn't the gutter snake talk? If you know the answer, email Miss Chan or put your guess in your class seesaw. Good luck. I hope you enjoyed today's student announcements. I did. If you want to host the next student school's morning announcements, just email Miss Shan. Thanks for watching. I'm Kestrel signing off. Until next time, have a great day. Well, it's all